I scouted, sir. They've locked the front, and I've seen evidence of snares. Also, maybe it's nothing, but I spotted several statues of the woman Delilah. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was worth mentioning.
It means trouble. Anything else?
They're getting in and out of the house somehow, but I haven't spotted it. Sorry, sir. Best I can do.
Good enough. I'll take it from here.
Up and went for me. I had to crush its skull to be sure.
Thank you. Don't think I'm on your side, because I'm not. If you raise a hand to any of my sisters but Delilah, you'll answer to me.
Understood. What have you got?
When her ritual's done, Emily Caldwin's mind will be gone, and Delilah will look out through her eyes the rest of her life.
And Delilah will rule as Empress.
That's up to you. I've got my money. That's all I need.
Wait. What about a way in?
Use the crypt. There's a lever that opens one of the tombs. The lever is kept in the shed. That's all I can tell you. Sisters speak with a tiny shudder of awe in their voices, like stupid schoolgirls.
No.
Or the statues. And then we'll descend on him like a murder of crows, and we'll pick his...
Sisters has wandered away from here.
Thank you.
He drowned thinking of what Lord Brutmore. Listen for the heels of his boots. He is heels like ties.
Thank you.
see?
Yes. I put the lantern back in our lady's studio. It'll be ready when she calls.
But I don't think Delilah will return this way. When she calls us, it will be to Dunwall Tower.
Probably true.
Evie, may I confess something to you? Promise not to tell the others.
Of course. You can always confide in me.
When I was in the studio, I painted the mark on my hand, just to see. It was foolish, I know, but I couldn't help myself.
Never be ashamed of your ambition. It's why she chose you.
Thank you. Your words are always exactly what I need, Evie. If only my birth sisters had been more like you.
Well, if they had, they'd still be alive, wouldn't they?
Make me eat anymore. I can't. Brother Marcus, I denounce the Abbey. Wandering gaze, lying tongue.
What happened to you?
I denounce the oracles.
Dies.
The oracles. They saw. The Caldwin girl is the key.
The girl in the painting.
Where's Delilah?
We know you're here, you scullywog.
Come, little toad. Come
Leave
to
for
me.
Us.
Get around him.
You have many talents, Dowd, and they've served you. Delilah's talents are quite different. She creates images, but she does more. She captures spirit. She insinuates her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. I gave you Delilah's name, and you followed it to this moment. You see now what hangs in the balance. Emily's life, Delilah's ambition, an empire in the act of crumbling. In your long life, I've rarely seen you act with such consummate grace. I give my mark sparingly, and I don't play favorites. But I will watch this with unusual attention.
The Void. Time to see what you've really got, Delilah.
Emily Caldwin, daughter of Jessamine Caldwin, heir to the Empire of the Isles. I call out to you from the Void. I call you with ochre from Morley, carmine beetle shells, zirconin lazurite, viridian bile. The tones of your flesh I tempered with Pandician chalk. The same loom that spun the fabric of your dresses made this canvas. I made my brushes from the hairs of your own scalp. Emily, you cannot ignore me. My power is too deep. My reach too long. Brush touches canvas. Brush touches void. And now I see you, Emily Caldwin. I breathe.
Are all artists narcissists?
I can feel what you do. Mornings in the pub. I feel the cold night air of the ruin where you sleep. Stink of the river. I touches the mind. Mind touches the world. Feel your love for Corvo of Time. And your lost mother. For your caretaker, Callista. I feel your fear in the night. Your hunger to learn. To become someone important. My hunger too. My fear. You are becoming mine. We are nearly finished. Close your eyes, Emily. Sleep forever. Feel the void open beneath you. Make room for me. Give in to me, Emily. Give in to me now! Paint flows. Blood flows. Life goes. Out with the old, in with the new. You've lived in his bones long enough. Sweet young girl. Finished. It is complete. I am... What? What's happening? This is all wrong! What am I becoming? Outsider's blood? Is this some trick? Go!
No one will ever know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation. I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Cirkonos to Dunwall as a boy, made my living as a killer, one of the few who've heard the outsider's voice. I murdered an empress, but saved her daughter, who will one day rule the empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes. Inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you pass through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.